fourth grade is going to be split in Tennessee. There's a fair component on problem sets, and that's because the problem sets are going to be hard to and the kind of things you learn, for example, doing these computational problems, is somewhat different from what you learn and what you demonstrate on an exam. Right? So that's why it's not all. To say something more about these classes, two midterms and an exam, the dates are on your Okay, so problem sets, you can read about this, but basically, every Friday, 7 o'clock, they're going to be due. A box out to the third floor of building 6 and the fourth floor of building 8. So the idea is that we'd like you to have a weekend to catch up and start reading for the next week. That's why they're due just before dinner on Friday. That being said, we understand that sometimes there are a lot of problem sets, sometimes you're overwhelmed something else, that's fine. You can turn it in for 80% credit until Monday morning at 10 a.m. when we're going to post. We won't be accepting problem sets after that, unless you get written from the So this is a key part of the class. Only 5% of the grade. It's rated really only on participation. Right? But this is an essential element of what we call flipped classroom. And so today's class is going to be rather different from the rest of the semester. Today is more like a lecture, I'd say. Whereas the rest of the semester, there will not be any PowerPoint slides, and it will be very much. Very interactive. In order to facilitate that, there are a number of different elements. One is that we do require reading before class, and the way that we encourage you to do the reading is that we ask you to answer questions. What you do is by 10 p.m. the night before, just 3 questions. A couple sentences, but not you're supposed to have to do a lot of work. It's just that if you did the reading, you'd be able to give your take on it, think about it a little bit, and then Andrew will go over the answers, and will send out his favorite answer. So your answer will occasionally be recommended there if you say something. Now, it's really important to have done this reading and talk about the material stuff before, because the idea is that in class we really like to engage what you might call higher level learning, right? So it's not just this idea that, the traditional lecture, right, in a row, when we're very century, you don't have a textbook. So what you need is for me to stand up front and read. And that's fine, except that it's better for you to read it. And you can read it outside of class, think about it a bit, and then when you come to class, we can actually discuss it. Right? And in particular, I'll give you my take on the material, what kind of research that I'm excited about in the area that's published recently. And we will also try to get you involved via black cards. Color cards, so we can ask successful questions. Drop an apple, does it go up, down, left, right, and then you guys get the vote, right? And then after the vote, we will often have to pair up, and the goal there is to kind of convince your neighbor that you're right. And after that, you might stand to the board. So the idea there is that it's very important for you to kind of try to cut the material, make your best guess, and then I think this is actually one of the and I'll say also that this basic technique is the result of the field of education. There are very, very this sort of flipped classroom active learning style is actually it is more fun, but that's not actually why I'm doing it. I'm doing it because people have spent their lives studying this topic. Any questions about this class questions or my notion of active learning. Okay, you can mark your calendars in advance. We do have a final. It's not been scheduled yet. Sometime the week, December 15th, 19th. So if you are looking online for late tickets back home, right? After December 19th. Or if you'd like, you can wait a couple of weeks. We have two required textbooks for the class. The first is an instruction system file. I think it's a wonderfully clear, kind of exciting instruction system topic. The flip side of being wonderfully clear is that it's a little, that you could explain that it's too simple. Right? What that means is that we will be supplementing the book in a variety of ways. Both separate notes and also by extensive. The second half of the third class will be reading some chapters on evolutionary dynamics. Again, a very nice, I think these are both books that you're all interested in. There are two other books that I think you might want to recommend buying. The first, Essential Cell Biology, which is kind of like the version of the cell is everything you ever want to know about the cell, and more than you want to know about the cell, whereas Essential Cell Biology is a wonderful book. We read this in my lab as a project. We read a chapter and got together over lunch, and we've been around the table and we've been through all the questions alternated and discussed. It's really wonderful. It focuses on the ideas, on how you get to memorize some things. But every now and then, you can memorize something. But I would say that if you're really interested in biology, and then finally, there's a book called Knowledge That Is Chaos by Jason Wilkins, which is a beautiful introduction. Not see the book, I encourage you. And in particular, some of the topics on building out life changes.